Till now, we have discussed about the different techniques of sterilization. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about the monitoring of the sterilization. Monitoring of the sterilization is nothing but involving the checking of the sterilization technique by means of sterilizer gauzes, computer displays or printouts or documenting, which is going to record the pressure, temperature and exposure time. For monitoring of the sterilization process, there are different types of indicators available, that is physical indicators, chemical indicators or biological indicators. Such indicators are frequently used in the combination for it. Sterilization is nothing but a process designed to kill all microbes. So, sterilization monitoring will be involving the assessing of the effectiveness of the sterilization process so that problems with the use or functioning of the sterilizer can be detected and corrected. So this will be helpful in assuring the sterilization. The sterilization indicators are like spore strips, indicator tape or routine monitoring or qualification and load monitoring of the sterilization process. They indicate whether the conditions during any sterilization are of defined level or not, so that properly the microbial inactivation has been done. So to check the assurity of the sterilization, the monitoring of the sterilization is carried out by means of different types of indicators, so we are going to see one by one. In the physical indicators, first if we take the heat sterilization process, then here one temperature record chart is made for each sterilization cycle, and along with this cycle can be maintained for dry heat sterilization as well as moist heat sterilization, and it is recommended that the temperature should be taken from the coolest part of the loaded sterilizer. Heat distribution and penetration within a sterilizer can be gained by use of thermocouples placed at selected sites in the chamber. Autoclaving depends upon the steam under pressure as well as temperature. So, pressure measurements is an essential part of the physical monitoring of the process. In addition, periodic leak tests are performed in pre-vacuum steam sterilizers to assess the efficiency of air removal before the introduction of steam. In case of gaseous sterilization procedures, elevated temperatures are monitored for each sterilization cycle by temperature probes. Pressure and humidity measurements are recorded. Gas concentration is measured by increasing the pressure, while in case of radiation sterilization process, plastic dosimeters, which gradually darkens in proportion to radiation absorbed. So these dosimeters gives an accurate measurement of the radiation dose. So by this plastic dosimeter, the radiation sterilization procedure can be monitored. And in case of filtration sterilization process, bubble point pressure test is performed. This test is used to determine the pore size of the filters. It is also used to check the integrity of certain types of filter devices immediately after use. The basic principle of the test is that weighted filter is subjected to an increasing air or nitrogen gas pressure differential. The pressure difference is recorded when the first bubble of gas breaks away from the filter. This will be related to the maximum pore size. When the gas pressure is further increased slowly, there is eruption of the bubbles. That is, we can see the greater rate of bubbles over the entire surface. The pressure difference here is related to the mean pore size. A pressure differential below the expected value would signify that the filter is damaged one. Another test is also used for the measurement of diffusion of gas through a weighted filter at a pressure below the bubble point pressure. In this test, if the diffusion rate is fast than the expected, then it would indicate a loss of filter integrity. A filter is considered ineffective when unusual rapid rate of filtration occurs. So this will be also indication of the sterilization by filtration. Now we will move towards the filtration by chemical. Here in the chemical indicator or chemical monitoring of the sterilization process is based upon the ability of heat, steam, sterilant gases and ionizing radiations, which can alter physical characteristics of a variety of chemical substances. This change should take place only when sterilization cycle has been successfully completed. This change will be considered as sterility check. That is, ideal indicator response is not always achieved. Chemical indicators generally undergo melting or color change. The relationship of this change to the sterilization process being influenced by the design of test device. Here are some examples of chemical indicators for monitoring sterilizing process. So first is the autoclaving or use of dry heat. Here the basic principle will be the temperature sensitive color solution will be used. And device here is the Brown's tube. Here sealed tubes which are partly filled with a solution which changes the color at elevated temperature. So rate of color change in proportion to the temperature is measured. And here parameters monitored are temperature and time. When we are considering heating in autoclave only, then steam sensitive chemical is used. Usually an organic chemical in a printing ink filled into a chamber or a carrier material, a combination of moisture and heat process. So here we can obtain the darkening of the ink. So it will be indicator for the sterilization. Here parameter monitored is the saturated steam. Then comes is the ethylene oxide, that is gaseous sterilization. It will be having use of reactive chemical. We are going to use the indicator paper which will be impregnated with a reactive chemical which undergoes a distinct color change on reaction with ethylene oxide in presence of heat. So this will be showing the color change heat as well as moisture and gas concentration, temperature, time, relative humidity. These are the parameters which are monitored by using this indicator paper. Next comes is the sterilization by using low temperature steam sterilization and use of formaldehyde also. Here again we are going to use the reactive chemical. Similarly, indicator paper impregnated with the temperature sensitive reactive chemical which will undergoing the color change during the sterilization process. Here gas concentration, temperature, time, these are the parameters which are monitored. Then last comes is the radiation sterilization. Here the radiochromic chemicals are used as a basic material. The plastic devices impregnated with the radiosensitive chemicals, these devices will undergo the color change at relatively low radiation doses. Here parameter only indicate exposure to the radiation. So these are different types of chemicals used for different type of sterilization method, and it will be having either complete melting of that particular indicator material, or there will be a drastic color change. As previous it will be different color and after it will be a different color. So it will indicate the sterilization is complete or not. So it is going to prove the completion of reaction. Comes is the biological indicator. Biological indicators are used in thermal, chemical or radiation sterility. They are in the form of suspension of bacterial spores which are in water or in the culture medium. These will be packed in the dummy packs. These may be spores. Now either this will be suspension. This will be suspension, or sometimes it will be placed on the aluminium paper, that is pores will be dried on the aluminium paper, or sometimes the plastic carrier can be used. These are placed in a dummy pack located at a strategic site inside the sterilizer. For gaseous sterilization, these may be also placed within a tubular helix device. After sterilization, these aqueous suspensions or solutions of spores are aseptically transferred to an appropriate nutrient medium, which is then incubated and periodically examined for signs of growth. Spores of Bacillus stereothermophilus are packed in a sealed ampoules of the culture medium and are used for steam sterilization monitoring, and these may be incubated directly at 55 degrees Celsius. This eliminates the need of an aseptic transfer. Aseptic transfers are also avoided by use of self-contained units where the spore strip, this will be spore strip or nutrient medium which is present in the same device, ready for mixing after use. Bacterial species used must be non-pathogenic and should possess above average resistance to the particular sterilization process. Resistance is decided from spore destruction curve obtained upon exposure to sterilization process. Recommended biological indicator spores and their decimal reduction times, that is nothing but a D value. One of the long standing criticism is that incubation period required in order to confirm a satisfactory sterilization process imposes an undesirable delay on the release of the product. So this problem has been overcome with respect to steam sterilization. Spore enzyme, D-glucoside, glucosidase is used, it converts a non-fluorescent substrate into fluorescent product in 1 hour. So infiltration sterilization, Serratia marcinensis, a small gram-negative rod-shaped bacterium, has been recommended in the pharmaceutical codex. In membrane filter industry, Serratia marcinensis is usually reserved for the filters of having pore size 0.45 micrometer. Pseudomonas diminuta is used for the filters which are having pore size of 0.22 micrometer. So here in the next species which are used for the determination or checking of the sterilization process. So here we can see that for autoclave, that is sterilization by using autoclave, two species can be used, that is one is the Bacillus stereothermophilus and Clostridium sporogenus. Both are having inoculum size more than 10^5. The D value for Bacillus stereothermophilus is 1.5 and for Clostridium sporogenus the D value is 0.8. Now for dry heat sterilization, Bacillus subtilis Wernigeri is used, which is again having the similar inoculum size, but the D value timing is 5 to 10 minutes. For ethylene oxide sterilization, Bacillus subtilis Wernigeri is used. Here inoculum size is 5 × 10^5. Then the D value is 2.5 minutes. For low temperature steam and formaldehyde sterilization, Bacillus stereothermophilus is only used. The D value is 5 minutes. And for ionizing radiation, Bacillus pumilus is used, which is having inoculum size 10^7 to 10^8. Now in the next video, we will discuss about what is this D value. Okay, so till then, bye.